Hello, everyone. I'm WDSU sports anchor Fletcher Mackel. We've got a lot to get to, so let's not waste any time. We start with the New Orleans Pelicans, our city's NBA franchise, in action on Sunday night in Cleveland, taking on the Cavaliers. And if the Pels were going to be successful and pick up their second consecutive victory, they needed the league's biggest point guard to play big. That's right. 20-year-old superstar Zion Williamson is now the Pels' point guard. 6'7", 285. He is a one-man wrecking ball at that position. And no surprise here, Zion fantastic again on Sunday evening. He goes for 38 points. He grabs 9 rebounds and dishes out 4 assists. But the Cavs, they were gritty and gutty. They actually led by 10 after the first quarter and by 6 at halftime. Kevin Love, he had 19 points. The good news, the Pelicans locked it down in the fourth quarter, holding the Cavs to just 15 points, and New Orleans got a tremendous effort from Najee Marshall, one of the unsung players, a guy not in the rotation, but who played on Sunday because of all the injuries. He plays 31 minutes, and he finishes with 15 points as the Pelicans pick up a nice win on the road.
I think ultimately our intensity on defense changed the game for us. You know, we were real sloppy at the beginning. I really say up until the third quarter, but our intensity on defense changed the momentum for the game for us.
The Pelicans right back in action on Monday evening, taking on the Sacramento Kings. The associate head coach of Sacramento is former Pelicans head coach Alvin Gentry. After Monday night's game, the Pelicans have another home game Wednesday against the New York Knicks. Now to golf and history at Augusta National. Hideki Matsuyama is the 2021 Masters champion. Matsuyama delivered Golf Mad Japan the grandest and greenest prize of them all, a victory at the Masters to become the first Japanese winner of the green jacket. At one time on Sunday, he had a 6-shot lead. Then he bogeyed 3 of the final 4 holes, but he still hung on to win, firing a final round 73.
I'm honored and thrilled to be able to win here at the wonderful Augusta National. And want to thank all of you great fans for coming out today and cheering.
The Masters wrapping up always means that the Zurich Classic of New Orleans is just around the corner. Our city's PGA Tour event, April 22nd through the 25th at the TPC of Louisiana. Right now, 4 of the top 10 players in the world have committed, and more are expected to join the field over the next few weeks. Let's take a walk around the diamond now. The LSU Tigers going for a sweep of Kentucky, but the Wildcats had something to say about that. Colton Kessler with a 2-run bomb in the first inning. It was ugly for LSU. They do take 2 of 3, but they fall on Sunday. Final score, 13-4. Closer to home, check out the leather. UNO's slick fielding shortstop Darren Willis with the great grab, but the Privateers fall against Sam Houston State. Final on Sunday, 7-1. UNO does take the series from Sam Houston. Softball action now. Back-to-back bombs for the LSU Tigers. This is Taylor Pleasants. LSU scores 11 unanswered runs, and they pull off a tremendous comeback to sweep Missouri over the weekend. Final score on Sunday, 12-5. One more college item. Congratulations to the UNO tennis team, the men's and women's teams, co-champions of the Southland Conference. They finish 10-1 in conference play and 6-0 at home. And finally, the NFL draft is less than a month away. The New Orleans Saints will be picking 28th overall in the first round. When it comes to biggest needs for the black and gold, probably cornerback, linebacker, and wide receiver. I caught up with Ross Jackson from the podcast Locked On Saints, and I talked to him about a linebacker that he really likes, Notre Dame's Jonathan Owosu-Koromoa. He's a player that may not make it to 28, but if he does, he seems like a natural fit next to DeMario Davis. And Jackson says, if he's there, the Saints should sprint to the podium to select him.
He's somebody that fills a role that they're looking for. It's certainly one that we saw them benefit from with Quan Alexander when they traded for him last season, as being that linebacker that operates in pass coverage. It's really good at keying and diagnosing and firing and getting involved in the run game, even if he's not the most sure-fire tackler like Quan Alexander, you know, had that reputation. But he certainly made himself very, very available in all of those different situations because of his ability to play sideline to sideline. And JOK definitely provides exactly that same type of talent.
The Saints will have 8 total selections in the upcoming 2021 NFL draft. To see a complete 7-round Saints mock draft that I produced, you can go to WDSU.com or any of our social media platforms right now. And that's a look at sports. Reporting from my home, I'm Fletcher Mackel, WDSU News.